What if you could upgrade your laptop just like a desktop PC? Impossible, right? Think again. This is transformation. If you're a DIY PC builder, you may have already seen these before, but if not, this is going to blow your mind. This is a framework laptop. More specifically, this is a pre-production model of the Framework 16. It would be an understatement to say this is a special piece of technology here. It's so special that a certain well-known tech influencer invested $250,000 in the company. It's not me, I promise. I wish I had that kind of money just laying around to throw into tech things like this. This thing has an incredible modular design with multiple expansion bays, and it's user upgradable too. Now we'll talk about that in a second, but let's just check out these expansion bays. They let you mix and match your I/O depending on what you need in a moment. Let's say you are at your BYOC or bring your own PC event like QuakeCon, but you want to use a second monitor, no problem. Slap in an HDMI or a DisplayPort expansion card and you're ready to go. How about more USB ports? USB-A or USB-C? Why not both? What if you need a micro SD card? Framework has you covered. Or maybe you need an Ethernet port or a headphone jack, because you know, we still use those things in 2023. And we do, Apple, we still do. Well, you're in luck. And despite what Apple thinks, these modules do exist too. But if you don't want to use any of those, what could you use? Well, Framework has storage expansion options that fit in those slots as well. But that's not all, like every other infomercial. What if you wanted a laptop with like a number keypad? Well, you could have that if you wanted. What about more RGB or an LED matrix to accent your keyboard? Framework has that. What if you wanted to keep things simple, but just add a few splashes of color to your bezel with a magnetic replacement? Well, you could do that too. That's the beauty of Framework 16. It's kind of a canvas. And it can be what you need to be at the moment, but it has room to be completely modified as needed. At the heart of this entire thing is these magnets that allow you to shift things left, right, center, changing numpads, changing your mouse pads, changing all sorts of things that are right here, both on the top and then of course even with the bezel. The same thing at the bottom. It's just about simple mechanics that allow you to just easily unclip and slide in the slots that you need. Honestly, it's so simple, I can't believe someone hasn't thought of it before. Let's talk about the power. At the heart of the Framework 16 is AMD Ryzen 7040H series of mobile processors. For this model, you have a choice between a Ryzen 7 7840HS or Ryzen 9 7940HS. Both equipped with Radeon 780M internal graphics cards. There will also be a 13-inch model as well. That one will have either a Ryzen 5 7640U or Ryzen 7 7840U, both with AMD's integrated Radeon 700M graphics. The 13-inch model has more limited expandability, but the 16-inch model, which we have right here, this is where things get wild. You can add a GPU module to this laptop. That's right, user upgradable GPUs in this laptop. Now this specific expansion is kind of limited right out of the gate. Framework offers a GPU expansion module with AMD's Radeon RX 7700S. While we haven't seen the desktop version of the 7700 GPU yet, we do know that this mobile variant will have 8 GB of GDDR6 VRAM feeding 32 compute units. So let's talk about the price. If you're looking to pick up a Framework 16, you know what? It's not really gonna break the bank and you still get a lot of options. First, you can do one of them as a DIY kit, which is starting at $1,399, or you can customize it and get a pre-build option from Framework for $1,699. In both scenarios, you can figure it down to the parts you want with it. So if you wanted to keep things super basic, you could absolutely do that. Or if you happen to catch a deal on like an NVMe drive or RAM, like we post like weekly over at Robeytech.com, you can bring those parts to the build with no issue whatsoever. This is great for cost savings because you're going to have some other expenses here, especially with the DIY kit where things like the power cable are extra. Individual modules range in price from $9 for like USB ports to $19 for the other I/O expansions, or the storage expansion modules are gonna cost you $45 for 256 and up to $125 for 1 TB. The GPU expansion module will be $400, which kind of hurts a little bit, but it's not out of line with current GPU prices. So that's a bit on pricing, but when are we actually gonna see these things in the wild? And when can we expect other GPU modules? That is a great question, but we can only speculate on the first one at this time. At the time of the making of this video, demand for the Framework 16 was so high that the company was taking pre-orders for their 10th batch of both Ryzen 7 and Ryzen 9 configurations. The estimated shipping window for both modules is sometime within Q1 of 2024. We are absolutely stunned by the Framework 16, and we cannot wait to see the platform not only grow, but hopefully inspire other manufacturers to develop products for it. But you know what? We want to know what you think. Let us know down in the comments below. Would you build a Framework laptop? Should we try and get one to build on stream? Not that it actually takes very long. You've seen a lot of the configurations right here in the B-roll. Now, while you're down there, why don't you go ahead and slap that subscribe button, whip that like button, and ring that notification bell so you get a notification each and every time we post a video like this right here on Robeytech. Also, if you want to discuss these laptops or any other tech things, go ahead over to our Discord server, discord.gg/Robeytech. Great place to talk about these very same things. You may go ahead and make a friend. Anyway, guys, I hope you enjoyed this video, and we look forward to watching you on the next one.